Hello, good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Welcome to Prince Miller Entertainment TV. Subscribe to the channel. So follow us on Twitter at PMillerENT. We are on Instagram at Prince Miller Entertainment. We are also available on our Facebook account, Prince Miller Entertainment. Our videos are now available on our Instagram account and also on our Facebook account. Anika. So guys, welcome to another edition of Daily News. Breaking news. Okay, it's a show where we talk about national news, serious news, and top headlines in Zimbabwe and surround. So, ZAC, Zimbabwe Anti-Corruption Commission, recovers US dollar 100 million in assets. You know, the Zimbabwe Anti-Corruption Commission, ZAC chairperson, Lois Matanda Moyo, yesterday said her first year in the hot seat had led to recover of assets worth US dollar 100 million that were hidden by crooks. And yesterday marked the first year in office by Matanda Moyo and her commissioners. Matanda Moyo said ZAC would now focus on, among other things, completing and submitting 80 dockets to the National Prosecutor Authority, NPA, for prosecution by end of December this year. This comes as President Emmerson Mnangagwa recently launched ZAC's strategy, where he called for a tougher action against corruption and urged law enforcement agents to timelessly conclude prosecution of graft-related cases. The commission saw the need to reconstitute and strengthen its assets recovery unit, which has already seized assets from the suspected criminals worth millions of US dollars. To date, the commission has recovered over US dollar 100 million worth of assets, thanks to the attachment of the money laundering and proceeds of crime amendment act of 2019, which empowers the seizure or the seizing of unexplained wealth. Matanda Moyo said yesterday while making team's first anniversary. Increased collaboration with the enforcement authorities of the unexplained wealth orders housed in the National Prosecution Authority and the Zimbabwean Revenue Authority, ZIMRA, we foresee the commission far exceeding its target of recovering Zimbabwe dollars 300 million worth of assets by the end of the year. Recovery of externalized proceeds of crime has also been given a boost through the establishment of agreements with reputable international partners who specialize in asset tracing and recovery. She said further, the work of the commission on investigations has already seen two cabinet ministers appearing before the courts for criminal abuse of duty as public officers, leading to them being relieved of their duties. Currently, a former minister and a senior government official are serving jail terms for criminal abuse of office. Many other cases for senior officials in government ministries, public entities and private sector are pending before the courts. Several investigations are underway to bring many culprits to book, Matanda Moyo added. She was referring to the cases which include the jailing of former energy minister Same Undenge, who is serving a 2.5-year jail term for corruption. Also, former cabinet ministers Obadiah Moyo and Priska Mufumira were arrested for graft related cases. They've both been fired from the government while their cases are at different stages at the Harare Magistrate Courts. Matanda Moyo yesterday also revealed that ZAC had set up a systems compliance unit which has assignments in reviewing, recommending and strengthening corporate governance systems at National Pharmaceutical Company, NetFem, Zimbabwe School Examination Council, ZIMSEC, presidential scholarships, recruitment of nurses, and most recently on the procurement of COVID-19 materials. The commission is also currently seized with the research in a number of key areas, namely public financial management, public procurement, mining sector, health services delivery, fuel sector, and maize meal subsidiary. The findings and the recommendations from the research will be presented to the relevant ministers, ministries and parliament in order to plug loopholes that enable corruption, she added. Moyo said while the past 12 months had witnessed major accomplishments, Zaki has encountered many challenges, including resource constraints. I'm pleased to announce that we have successfully crafted an anti-corruption commission lay bill that has since been submitted to the Attorney General to be brought before Parliament. We will recover at least $100 million in assets, and it's according to the Zach chairperson Louis Matanda Moyo, who is also a judge, and it's a high court judge. So I recover 100 million of assets, and so I'm going to happy, but I recover more. But you know, but you know what, as I said earlier on yesterday, in Zimbabwe we tine vanhu vane mari. In Zimbabwe we have people who have money. Mari yenyika irimo vanhu. Few individuals mane mari. We don't need to look for investors. My investors at now dara tinongodwa tinongoti mari idzodzoka dzingodzoswa munyika then nyika yose nyika yofamba ikuva kuenda mberi, because we keep on looking for investors, we keep on waiting for people to come and invest in Zimbabwe, but that's not going to happen anytime soon, you know, because mari iri matiri, mari iri muwanhu. And it's Zimbabwe, Maredu, Irimovano, and Nivava, and Duane Maridis. So Zaki have been trying to do a good thing, but we all know Kuti. Sometimes Wangwacho, Vanenga, and Mosha Wacho, Vanenga, very related to other big guns, Kuti, our Kwanzo Batua. Dai Vajo Bato, Nivangwacho, Vasanga Batua, and it's Mosha Zingatangova, Mosha Zingatangore Kira Kunavano, Vananga Sanga Dingwayo. I just hope Kuti. They should prosecute everybody. I think I won't bat go and most of those. And we saw what happened with this whole drug international situation. I still believe Kuti, although Obadiah Moyo are one of those guys, but there are so many people who were part of that deal. Wanafana rakuwa kunge wari mojizarira, you know, because Kuti madira kadaro aina sofambe mushi. Panenge pane ma big guns vanenge vachikwezvera kutoi vachikwezvera, you know. So let's hope kuti Zach will actually be independent and do a good thing and prosecute people vanonga vasungwe, munhu ngaavharirwe, you know. Let's not select mbava, mbava mbava, mwana wenyoka mwana wenyoka. So guys, I talk to you in the comment section. Muiona sei kuti vari kudzizoni ivo vari cover 100 million in assets, and they also associate themselves with the international partners. Remember, we have so many, we have my ministers on my bank accounts, SA, UK, even if kuna America, wakakanda mariko, wakasa mariko kuna Switzerland, kuna China. There are people who have put millions of in foreign currency in foreign countries. So she is saying that they've partnered up with other financial institutions abroad to try to bring money back into Zimbabwe. And that is Rakadaro, because we need money, we need to pay our nurses and doctors who are on strike at the moment. Guys, I talked to him in the comment section. I just thought, you know what, this is interesting. 100 million in assets, is 100 million US dollar in assets in Maraga Wanda. That's a lot of money. So, Makurokoto kuna Zach for doing a great job, but we want a free and fair in terms of if arrest and side one. Guys, talk to me in the comment section. Do you think kuti chokwadi kuti varikavha 100 million years kana kuti varongoti varaidwana momza vandira? So guys, talk to me. We are also available on our Instagram account, also our Facebook account, Tiri Kwa Omana. Our videos are now there. If you cannot come here on YouTube, you can also watch our videos on our Instagram account and Facebook account. It's Prince Miller Entertainment. Guys, Moskwera Mushe, Morara Mushe, good morning. Talk to me in the comment section. Zach recovers 100 million US dollar in assets, and 80 people are to be arrested by the end of the year. We keep you up to date. Corruption. Thank you very much for listening. Yeah, this is Daily News, Breaking News with Prince. Bless up.